Right now, Minnesota ski areas are embracing those colder temperatures, perfect for snowmaking. Our Chris Hrabski shows us they're anxious to get you out on the slopes.
Well, it's cold enough for me to pull out my I'm no longer messing around boots, which means it's cold enough for Buck Hill to start making some serious snow.
Best day of the year. Well, in my opinion, it's calm before the storm.
Dashing through the snow on a Black Friday ATV, Buck Hill has begun its annual snow make-a-thon.
When it's closer to 32, humidity plays a role, how much moisture is in the snow. So in order to just make really good quality snow, that's typically around that temp where the snow quality just kind of gets amplified a little bit.
No skiers or boarders yet, but onlookers like Herb and his buddy Barney.
He's never seen snow.
Checking out the pretty snow before becoming a snowbird.
Going back, I'll be in the next weekend, I'll be back down in Fort Myers.
Mid-20s weather, a welcome sign for business.
The goal is to get as much snow down as possible in as short a period of time as possible so that we can open up hopefully next weekend.
An hour north at Wild Mountain in Taylor's Falls, more snow is being made to blanket the season.
We're going to be opening tomorrow from 10 a.m. to 9 p.m. We're going to have a couple trails open, lots of snow. Finally got cold outside.
They'll have one run open Saturday, with others opening as soon as the snow accumulates. Skiers can't wait.
The excitement is building now it's finally got cold outside.
And like Buck Hill, this year, Wild Mountain is investing in comfort, more specifically, a cushy tushy.
Wild Mountain's finally adding a first padded chair. You know, we've gotten some older chairs here with wood seats on them, and so I'm excited to have that padded chair.
As he said, Wild Mountain expected to open tomorrow morning, as well as Trollhagen nearby. That opens tomorrow. Buck Hill expecting to open by next weekend. In Taylor's Falls, Chris Hrabski, Care 11 News.